Hello students, welcome back. In last lecture, you people have seen the concept of business communication, as well as we have seen the origin of word business communication. Similarly, we have also seen different definitions of business communication. Now, in today's lecture, we are going to talk about the principles of effective communication. As I told you, if you want to make your presentation, if you want to make your communication effective in our day-to-day life also, there are certain principles which we people have to follow to make our communication effective. So people, our students, my students, can ask me so many questions. So sir, I talk in our regular life also, in my regular life also, but nobody listens to me. I try to attract my friends, but they don't get attracted. So what should I do? So friends, my suggestion is that if you follow these principles in your day-to-day life of communication, definitely you will be able to impress your friends. Sometimes I also get some questions from my students. So sir, I try my level best to impress others, but I don't impress them. What should I do? What is a remedy? What is a solution for this? Friend, there are certain solutions to make your communication effective. Mostly, people are good in communication. What happens, you know? Most of the people, they are very good in communication, but they are not good in effective communication. Communication is only transmitting the information from one person to another person. Or in simple words, we just transfer the information, but only not just transformation of information is enough, but we need to transfer the information with other people in an effective manner. And if you want to make it effective communication, then definitely as a good communicator, you people have to follow some principles, certain principles to make your communication effective. So there are certain principles that we need to follow to make your communication effective. What are they and which are they? We are going to see those things in a very step-by-step manner. Before that, let me tell you something about effective communication. Everybody wants to make his or her communication effective because everybody wants some sort of praise from others. Suppose, see, if you have taken very nice lecture and somebody has not praised it, what will happen? It will something bad. Because we people have taken some efforts, and whenever we take some efforts, we want to, or we are very eager to listen to this. And this is what it means for, if you want to make your effective communication, definitely certain principles you people have to follow. So what are those principles that we need to follow to make our day-to-day communication effective? There are certain principles, one by one we are going to see. The first one, clarity of objective. See, this principle talked about the objective should be clear. See, behind every sort of communication, there is one objective. Without any objective, there is no communication. If you take an example of my lecture, what I am communicating, there is one objective. What I am taking my lectures by using this online platform, there is one objective. My objective is very clear. I want to teach you. See, physical teaching is not possible. Still, I'm going for online teaching. An objective is very clear. Objective is very clear. I want to teach you by using any media which will reach to you without physical teaching. So physical teaching is not possible. And this is what I have decided to go for online. So behind this online teaching also, the objective is same, which was there with the physical teaching. So here, this is what I said, this is the first principle. So principle says that whenever you want to make an effective communication, definitely there should be one objective, and that is clarity. Whatever objective you have decided that should be very clear. And that is important in the process of effective communication. Then, second one, proper message. See, if you want to create an impact of your communication, there should be a proper drafted message. Suppose, see, whatever message you write, whatever words and sentences you use, in your message, those should be properly drafted, properly written as far as the effectiveness is concerned. See, there are certain words, see, there are certain lines which will create impact on our minds because those are properly written, those are properly drafted. And if you want to make your communication effectively, there should be a proper writing of message. Proper message should be transferred from one person to another person. Proper message should be given to one person to another person. Then only it will be effective. If proper message is not there, suppose message is improper, message is incomplete, what will happen? It will not create good impression, it will not create effectiveness in the mind of listener, in the mind of receiver. And this is what there is the importance for this proper message also. So this one is the second principle to make your communication effective. Moving to the third one, knowledge of communication. See, if you have a knowledge of communication, definitely you can create effectiveness among the minds of receiver or among the minds of communicating. See, there are two parties which are always involved in the process of communication. Which are they? Communicator and communicator. In other words, sorry, communicator and communicating. In other words, we call them receiver and sender. So see, these two parties should have the knowledge of communication. It means what? Receiver should have the knowledge of communication and sender should have the knowledge of communication. Without the knowledge of communication, we cannot make the process of communication effective. So this is the third principle that we people have to follow anyhow in the process of communication. If we do not follow, if we don't have enough knowledge of communication, we cannot make our communication effective. Don't forget this. Moving on to the next one and the most important principle of communication, that is selection of media. Selection of media means what? If you want to make your communication effective, there should be a proper selection of media. So media plays very important role in the process of communication. See, everything is very nice. You have drafted a very nice message. You have the knowledge of communication, proper knowledge of communication. The message is also drafted well. Then there is a proper clarity of objectives also. But the message, the media which you people have selected is not up to the mark.